Hello everyone and welcome back to another Affinity Designing tutorial. I'm your host, Elias Arantopoulos. This time around, I will be showing you how to draw a fish using custom stroke profiles, then switching to the pixel persona for adding pixel brush paint strokes using some of the gouache brush presets Affinity Designer offers. So let's go ahead and see how that works. So inside Affinity Designer, I have already imported and placed a sketch. I will be drawing, in this case, the fish. I have reduced the layer's opacity as well as locked it so I don't accidentally move it. So inside the Layer Studio, I will create a new vector layer. So I will tap on the plus icon and add one. And at the same time, I'm going to rename this. So tap on the layer options and rename this to scales. That would be the scales of the fish. Hit enter, return. Now for drawing the sketch, I will be using the pencil tool. So tap on that, and from the context toolbar at the bottom, I'm going to adjust the settings. Here we have several choices. For example, under the controller, which controls whether the tool is sensitive to real pressure, we have the pressure option, the velocity option, and so on. So in this case, I will leave the controller set to none, and I will tap on the right arrow, and here we will get to the stabilizers, which smooth pencil lines as we draw. Under the stabilize options, we have no stabilizer, rope stabilizer, and window stabilizer. In our case, we will choose the rope stabilizer, where the brush is dragged as though it is attached with a rope. It creates tight angles and smooth lines. First, I'm going to tap on the Stroke Studio to increase the stroke width, like so. And then I'm going to go ahead and draw my first stroke line. So as you can see, this line is just a regular stroke line. So to make things more interesting, and when we draw, we will create pressure-sensitive pencil strokes with tapered ends. So inside the Stroke Studio and looking at the pressure input box, we will be using the display chart to create a custom pressure profile. So I'm going to drag both end nodes downwards, then tap halfway along the profile line to add a node, which I will drag upwards to taper the stroke according to the curvature of the graph, like so. So that is the first stroke. Let's go ahead and create another stroke. So what I do after is basically to tap on the node tool, and I'm selecting the nodes to reposition them, delete them if I see fit, or create new ones in order to create a smooth curved line. Now for this curve here, I'm going to tap on that node, tap on the trash icon to remove it, and tap along the curve to add a node and create a nice curvature. I can select this control handle here, and that control handle, and make a nice curved line. And I will be doing this throughout the continuation, drawing the scales of the fish. So for this next step, I'm going to go ahead and draw the contour of the fish. Again, I'm going to tap on the plus icon to create a new vector layer, which I'm going to rename this instead of layer 1, let's say to contour. Hit enter, return, and there you go. Again, I will tap to select the pencil tool, and inside the Stroke Studio, I'm going to create a custom pressure profile, but this time with a minor modification. First, I will go ahead and draw the first curved path. There you go. I will also increase the stroke width a bit. And second of all, I'm going to modify the pressure profile and taper the ends more than the ones I drew for the scales layer, because after all, this is a longer path. So I will tap and add one node here, and interactively you can see the result and how this stroke tapers, like so. I will do the same on the other end, add another node, and there you go. Again, I'm going to use the node tool to select nodes, reposition them along the path, or maybe remove or add more nodes in order to keep a smooth curved path. For the rest of the drawing areas for the mouth and the eye, I will also create two separate layers and name them accordingly. Now for the mouth, I will draw the path using the pencil tool, but this time around there will be no custom pressure profile. So I will tap to reset the pressure inside the pressure input box. As for the eye, I will create a custom pressure profile as I previously have done, and in both cases I will also use the node tool to select nodes, reposition them along the path, or maybe remove or add more nodes in order to have smooth curves. I will start the painting process inside Affinity Designer by focusing on each layer separately and by locking the rest of the layers, so I don't accidentally move any stroke paths. Then I will switch to the pixel persona, where I can add pixel brush strokes. From there on, I will tap to select the brush tool, and from the brushes presets, I will primarily be working with the gouache brushes, applying different brush color strokes from my own color palette. What is important here as you paint along, to adjust the width of the brush, how hard or soft your brush is, and the flow of the brush. And by the way, flow refers to how fast the brush effect is applied, with 100% to be immediate. Now, sometimes you will find yourself painting outside the targeted areas, but you can always paint on top or use the eraser tool to fix all that. Towards the end, I will switch back to the vector persona and apply some ink brushes from the brushes preset to the stroke paths and get some variation. Thank you everyone for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions below the comments section. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share the knowledge.